So this is Johnny, you do it. In this video, I'm going to show you how I fix a Keyfob where the battery terminal broke off. Make sure you hit that subscribe button right there and give this video a like. Okay, so I'm just going to clean this up a little bit. Okay, so I'm worried about the through holes first. Make sure they get on there. Okay, he's in place. It's good. So I'll apply a little bit of solder now to this. Okay, there we go. That is soldered. And we'll do the same thing to this side. Okay, that was easy. Alright, next part is this one here. I'll need to apply some force to it. Just a little bit of force, not a lot. Alright, and now I am bending this down a little bit so it forces contact with the battery when the battery is installed. Yep, so the battery is installed. Looks like it's going to work. So I think we got a winner here. All right, good. Next thing I want to do is clean this up with some alcohol. 90% alcohol. These pads here get a little stuff on them. This is the backside of the buttons. They're carbon feet, and I want to get any dirt off of them. Because when this button is pressed, it completes a circuit. And then this alcohol evaporates. My screwdriver in here with this, just to make sure this pad is definitely clean. So there you go. We have a... I'm certain that this will function because this was the fix I made on the other one. And now we will reassemble it.
Hey, it's John when you do it. Thanks for watching this video. I hope the... this will inspire you to go ahead and fix your own key fob instead of paying $150 for a new one. I think it's a little expensive, especially if you can fix it yourself. You just need a good soldering iron with a small tip and some rosin core. I used lead-based solder because this was manufactured at a time when lead was used. And anyway, hey, thanks for watching. Again, hit that subscribe button and give this video a like. And be sure to leave me a comment. Thanks for watching.